the alien compound. 10 isograms. If I understand your calculations, that's enough to increase your warp factor by what? 0.03% for 1 month? Unfortunately, that boost wouldn't get you very far. So you'd need to replenish the supply. And that means killing another life form. And then another. How many lives would it take to get you back to the Alpha Quadrant? I think you know the reason we're under attack. These aliens are trying to protect themselves from you.
63. That's how many more it will take. Every time I sacrificed one of those lives, a part of me is lost as well.
I might believe that if I hadn't examined your research. These experiments were meticulous and they were brutal. If you'd felt any remorse, you'd never have continued.
Starfleet Regulation 3, Paragraph 12. In the event of imminent destruction, a captain is authorized to preserve the lives of his crew by any justifiable means.
I doubt that protocol covers mass murder.
In my judgment, it did.
Unacceptable.
We had nothing. My ship was in pieces. Our dilithium was gone. We were running on thrusters. We hadn't eaten in 16 days. We had just enough power to enter orbit of an M-class planet. And lucky for us, the inhabitants were generous. They were called the Ankari, and they provided us with a meal and a few supplies, even some dilithium crystals. They even performed one of their sacred rituals to invoke spirits of good fortune from another realm to bless our journey. But these weren't spirits. They were nucleogenic life forms. Our scans revealed that they were emitting high levels of antimatter. Later that same night, we managed to obtain one of the summoning devices in exchange for an energy converter. We constructed a containment field that would prevent the life form from vanishing so quickly. But something went wrong.
Get it out of there.
We tried to send it back. We can't, but it was too late. We examined the remains and discovered it could be converted to enhance our propulsion systems. It was already dead. What would you have done? We traveled over 10,000 light years in less than 2 weeks. We'd found our salvation. How could we ignore it?
By adhering to the oath you took as Starfleet officers, to seek out life, not destroy it.
It's easy to cling to principles when you're standing on a vessel with its bulkheads intact, manned by a crew that's not starving.
It's never easy. But if we turn our backs on our principles, we stop being human. I'm putting an end to your experiments, and you are hereby relieved of your command.